Did Adam came from the heaven to India according to Christian deceiver? Yes. According to Muslims? No. Let's find the truth together.
Who remember where Adam is coming from? Anyone remember? According to Muslims, Adam is coming from India, specifically from Sri Lanka. And this is the footprint of Adam. But as you see, this is a temple for the Buddhas. And the Muslims, they are fighting over it. They want to take it because this is for Prophet Adam. But the Buddhas don't believe in Adam. Who is Adam? What Adam? This is a Buddha temple. So they believe that Adam was sent down to India, specifically Sri Lanka. And then Allah, he told Adam to go and do Hajj to Mecca. Now hold on. You know what? I want to go with this stupid claim. Just give me a second. I want to go to Sri Lanka. All right. Forgive my ignorance. I'm not so good in geography, so I need to see the map. By the way, if you don't believe me, you can search right now and you will see the Muslims and their websites. They are agreeing that Allah, he sent Adam to Sri Lanka. All right. This is a very serious, filthy teaching. This is a very serious, filthy teaching.
Sheikh Muhammad Salih Al-Munajjid. Nothing has been proven about the place where Adam came down to earth. Question. Is it true that Adam, peace be upon him, came down in India and that Hawa came down in Jeddah? Answer. Press A B to Allah. What is proven definitively in the Holy Quran is that Adam and Hawa, peace be upon them, came down from paradise to earth after they ate from the tree. Allah says, interpretation of the meaning, then the Satan, made them slip therefrom, the paradise, and got them out from that in which they were. We said, get you down, all, with enmity between yourselves. On earth will be a dwelling place for you and an enjoyment for a time, Al-Baqarah 236. With regard to the place where they came down on earth, the Quran does not say anything about it, and there is no Sahih, Marfu hadith in the Sunnah of the Prophet, blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, which explains that, although there are some da'if, weak, hadiths, such as the hadith that says, Adam came down in India and felt lonely. This was narrated by Ibn Asakir in Tariq Dimashq, 7/437, and classed as da'if by Sheikh Al-Albani in Al-Silsilah Al-Da'ifa, number 403. There are also other hadiths which speak of this matter, but their isnads are very weak. The only Sahih reports about this matter are the words of some of the Salaf, most of which are taken from the knowledge of the people of the book which were transmitted during their time. Such reports cannot be relied upon or trusted, and it is not permissible to believe in what they mention of things concerning which our religion is silent. Rather, they may be narrated for the purpose of storytelling only. Despite that, the scholarly opinions concerning this matter differ. Some of them said, Adam came down in India and Hawa came down in Jeddah. Some of them said that they both came down in India. Some of them said that Adam came down in a land between Mecca and Al-Taif called Dahna. Some of them said that Adam came down on Al-Safa and Hawa came down on Al-Marwa. Al-Hafiz bin Kathir, may Allah have mercy on him, said, Al-Saddi said, Allah said, interpretation of the meaning, get you down, all, Al-Baqarah 236. So they came down. Adam came down in India and the black stone and a handful of leaves from paradise came down with him, and he scattered them in India, and a perfume tree grew, which is the origin of what comes from India of perfume from the handful of leaves that Adam brought down. Adam only took them because of his sorrow at leaving paradise when he was expelled from it. Imran bin Uayna said, narrating, from Atta bin Al-Saib, from Sari'd ibn Jubay, from Ibn Abbas, who said, Adam came down from paradise in Dhana, in the land of India. Ibn Abi Hatim said, Abu Zara told us, Uthman bin Abi Shayba told us, Jarir told us, from Atta, from Sarid, from bin Abbas who said, Adam, peace be upon him, came down in a land called Dhana, between Makkah and Al-Ta'if. It was narrated that Al-Hasan al-Basri said, Adam came down in India and Hawa in Jeddah, and Iblis in the stonemason a few miles from Basra, and the serpent came down in Asbahan. This was narrated by bin Abi Hatim. Bin Abi Hatim said, Muhammad bin Amr bin al-Harith told us, Muhammad bin Sarid bin Sabiq told us, Amr bin Abi Qais told us, from bin Adi'i, from bin Umar, who said, Adam came down on Al-Safa and Hawa on Al-Marwa. End quote. Tafsir Al-Quran Al-Azim, 1/237. But all of these are words for which there is no evidence. And Allah knows best. But all of these are words for which there is no evidence. And Allah knows best.
Forgive my ignorance, I'm not so good in geography, so I need to see the map. All right. By the way, if you don't believe me, you can search right now and you will see the Muslims in their websites. They are agreeing that Allah has sent Adam to Sri Lanka. All right.
This is a very serious, filthy teaching. This is a very serious, filthy teaching.
With regard to the place where they came down on earth, the Quran does not say anything about it, and there is no Sahih, Marfu hadith in the Sunnah of the Prophet, blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, which explains that, although there are some da'if, weak, hadiths, such as the hadith that says, Adam came down in India and felt lonely. This was narrated by Ibn Asakir in Tariq Dimashq, 7/437. And classed as Daif by Sheikh Al-Albani in Al-Silsilar Al-Da'ifa, number 403. There are also other hadiths which speak of this matter, but their isnads are very weak. The only Sahih reports about this matter are the words of some of the Salaf, most of which are taken from the knowledge of the people of the book which were transmitted during their time. Such reports cannot be relied upon or trusted, and it is not permissible to believe in what they mention of things concerning which our religion is silent. Rather, they may be narrated for the purpose of storytelling only.
This is a very serious, filthy teaching.
By the way, if you don't believe me, you can search right now and you will see the Muslims in their websites. They are agreeing that Allah has sent Adam to Sri Lanka. All right.
This is a very serious, filthy teaching.
Such reports cannot be relied upon or trusted, and it is not permissible to believe in what they mention of things concerning which our religion is silent. Rather, they may be narrated for the purpose of storytelling only.
This is a very serious, filthy teaching.